And we are underway from NRG Stadium in Houston. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 25.
Let's go now.
They'll start on the ground with Pierce. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Well, this defense for the Eagles, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week. You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball, or maybe just 1 or 2 receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright.
Now this throw caught left side, and he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 36 yards on the play.
Things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us or their game plan today, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now back to throw. He'll get this into the hands of Nico Collins. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice game there. This one goes for 20. Their first possession of the game, and they're already going after double coverage.
That's a nice completion that can set the tone for things to come if they're able to keep finding ways to beat what the defense is throwing at them. They look like they're confident that they can get it done.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. They're going to look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll drop to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They are such a talented team at defending the perimeter and taking away throws to the outside. Great confidence, great skill.
The kick by Fairbairn is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. And the Texans are going to take possession of the football. So first interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if they're going to turn it into points.
First and 10, it's Pierce. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
We talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. Rifling one complete into the hands of Marshall. And the Texans are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
They'll run here with Pierce. And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Damian Pierce, his fifth rushing touchdown now on the year. And they are able to add on to their advantage. They go I formation, fullback.
It really is, but sometimes when you're able to bring it back and use it against other teams, they're not prepared for it. They haven't seen it in a while, and now you gain an advantage. We just saw that advantage result in a touchdown.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Well, Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early, first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen, and they need for it to happen now.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Throwing is Hurts. And he'll get that to Fournette complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Come on, come on.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They go play action with Hurts. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Fournette running right. And he is going to lose yardage here. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. Fournette once more on second down. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. That's what they needed. It's an 8-yard gain, and now third and 4 suddenly doesn't look so bad. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a third down coming up. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Touchdown, Eagles! Mark Marquez Valdes-Scantling. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
They're riding a two-game winning streak into this Thursday nighter. How easy is it when you're on a roll to stay on a roll given the quick turnaround?
Well, you would think it'd be pretty easy because everyone's locked in practice and meetings because everyone feels good about themselves. And for coaches, this is where they have to tell themselves, don't add too much, don't worry about game plans as much as players. So look at your play sheet and think, give it to the guys who play best, and don't worry about the rest of it.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And that is incomplete.
Well, you must be back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Taking a shot here for Marshall. And this one is incomplete.
The Texans at 4-3, a game over 500. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. On second down, here's Pierce. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. On play action, they'll throw. Taking a shot here for Marshall. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. On 4th down, out is the punter, Cameron Johnston, to boot it away. And the win last week punted 4 times as this one's away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. As mentioned, this one of the hottest teams in the NFL, riding that winning streak into this one. But now playing here on Thursday night, do you think that this helps or hurts their momentum?
Well, ordinarily, I'd say it hurts the momentum because now you get that short week. But when a team's playing as well as they are, it actually allows them to down focus and only worry about themselves and less about their opponent. So when you're playing well, you just worry about the things you're doing well and let the opponent deal with that.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one goes for 36 yards.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. This will be caught once again by Brown. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
I like like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop.
Touchdown! Quez Watkins, 27 yards. And the Eagles have taken the lead. Elliott on for the extra point. And oh, it's no good. For the second time now in this first half, he's missed an extra point. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. A break there for this offense as they will get a chance to start at the 40-yard line. Starting field position for the Houston Texans here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Pierce now up the middle. They find some open field here. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 35-yard line. First down, they go right back to Pierce. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Looking to throw. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down. They'll set up to throw. His throw caught at about the five. Touchdown, Texans. A great effort there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Texans have retaken the lead. Extra point by Fairbairn up and good. And the lead is up to five. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they, as mentioned, unbeaten to this point in the year, but you think this game, their toughest test yet.
I absolutely do, because to me, this is a good measuring stick game because they've been able to take advantage of the schedule. But here, this is another team leading its division with an eye on making a Super Bowl run, so this game is crucial.
Good work after the catch, going to net him 23 and a first.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
So, Charles, you know, offensively, this group really playing at a high level. 7-0. And we're still a long ways from discussing a potential unbeaten season, I think. But to use a golf expression, no blemishes on the card, at least to this point.
Yeah, unlike my teenage years where there were blemishes everywhere and the dermatologist was on speed dial. But I do think that...
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Darren Stingley picks it. And the Texans are going to have it here just past the 25. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And, you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
You know, are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday.
This is caught at the 20. A huge play there for Houston. 53 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of 2.
I do know from experience that if you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free, and kept them out of the end zone.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Back to throw. And that's complete to Marshall on the crossing route.
And the Texans are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Now a timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. He'll look to throw. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston.
Nico Collins from 4 yards out. And the Texans will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with them down 2 scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Going across the middle, and Goddard's got it. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Personally, I think they've got to go somewhere else with the football. They've got to bracket it out there in double coverage. Makes it hard to fit it in time after time.
It would have had to have been an absolutely perfect pass and not good enough.
Off the play fake, here's Hurts.
And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by MJ Stewart.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try to get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step toward forcing them to think bigger right now? Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports Halftime Report. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gaughton, getting set for quarter number three here. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. By no means certainly are they out of this contest. Two-score game, start of the third quarter, but you feel like if they don't get points and then they give up points, then it can become a slippery slope. This feels like an important possession.
Yeah, and that slope becomes even more slick if you come away empty-handed on this drive, because then you give them a chance to extend their lead. You need some kind of points here, even if it's just a field goal. It's what I call one of those calming drives, try and slow things down a little bit.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. Second and 10 from the 25. Hurts. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a three-yard gain there. Play action. Here's Hurts. This is caught. It's Brown. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That'll put him at 77 yards receiving for the ball game. It's a first down. Here's Hurts to throw. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in here for the sack. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Here comes the blitz as they look to throw. Wide open is Watkins. He's got him. A big play there for Philly. And even 50 yards.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other with each additional play.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. Third time's the charm on the extra point as he gets this one to go. And this is back to an 8-point game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You got to be careful right here.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. That's complete. It's Collins. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Looking for Marshall, but it's intercepted.
It's N'Kobe Dean with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take possession of the football.
Well, holding on to the lead at this stage in the second half, those are the types of plays you really want to try and stay away from.
And when you're a rookie, keeping your focus is something that you still have to work on all the time because there's so many distractions around you between the crowd noise and your coaches and your teammates. But the other part, you've got to learn how to finish. It's the two F's for a rookie quarterback.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Throwing is Hurts. Got a man. It's Brown. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown.
Well, fair to say, they've got something here in this rookie running back, and he's in for the second time of the ball game.
And, Brandon, it's a position where there's often a lot of turnover, a lot of competition at that spot. But he's proven to them that he wants to be the bell cow guy that his franchise can rely on.
Now that Eagle offense will stay out there as he'll go for two. And he'll get into the end zone, and those 2 points are going to tie the game.
He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. We got a brand new ball game, all even after that last touchdown, so every drive now becoming a little more critical here in the second half. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. Second and six. And his throw is incomplete.
Partner, for once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one-possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. They're going to look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away.
And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles' defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
They go play action with Hurts. He's got a man complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. How about a 39-yard pickup? They'll take him. They lulled them to sleep there, so to speak. That was all set up by the running game, wasn't it?
Another example of what all offensive coordinators tell us. When the running game's operating, it really opens up the playbook. And that's when they hit them with the play action. And you can see the defenders rushing towards the line of scrimmage, then scrambling back, trying to cover. Couldn't get there in time.
Well scripted. They had the big running play. Now the big passing play.
A tackle made by Thomas Booker.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Second and five now. Hurts out to the left there and complete to the tight end Goddard.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. A five-yard pass on the heels of a five-yard run. Good enough for the first. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
On first down, Hurts. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A well-executed 22-yard gain. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. Now a handoff running through the middle. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
They'll try again. And he's not going too far. In fact, stopped dead in his tracks at the 3.
2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for him.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and come back. It just never materialized.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. They'll try to run this one in, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A 3-yard touchdown run.
And the Eagles have broken our tie and have taken a 4th quarter lead. So what a comeback here. They looked like they might be down and out not too long ago, but they have rallied back to take a 4th quarter lead.
And I think we've got to give them nothing but credit for figuring things out on the fly, because mentally, they were on the ropes ready to go, and they hung in there and made some changes and adjustments, and that led to some big plays, and it turned this game on its ear.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And the pressure is on now. They're being shut out here in the second half after a decent first half offensively. And they need their best drive of the game right here. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Some coaches like to take the shorter, more reliable yardage, and some, they like to go for the big shot. No fear in risking a deep ball there, but it wasn't enough to get them the completion.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Blitz forthcoming as he'll look to throw. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Hassan Reddick in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number one. And, you know, they had 5 last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback, but just show them a lot of different looks. And they did that in the first half, you know, different. They got to him here in the second half. Now they've got to come up with a counter to that and maybe do something different.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there, the leg's still there? This has been a tough game.
60 Maverick! 60 Maverick!
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield in man coverage and make them ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Back to throw again. For Marshall, that's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 27 yards there, a first down.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Pierce takes it straight ahead. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
They'll drop to throw. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. That'll put him over 150 yards receiving now. Quite a ball game and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Now a handoff for Pierce. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. Once more, it's Pierce. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. Whistles now and a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the 2-minute warning. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Off the option, that's complete. Touchdown! A great effort there with his second touchdown of the night. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. The extra point, a vital one, and he gets it to go. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Texans will have solid field position here as they take over at their 45-yard line. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. On the ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
19.
Now back to throw. He's got his tight end. It's Tommy Trimble. On the move past the 40. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Okay, there's three timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Give to Pierce. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
And they'll go right back to Pierce. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. The run here with Pierce. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain that time, and it leaves him with third and 11 coming up. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. Now here's a timeout as they will indeed call it with 5 seconds to go and a chance with a field goal to win the game. So on is their kicker, and it's down to this. 2 for 2 tonight. This will be for the win. And his kick is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. He hasn't missed a kick all year. Why would he start now?
That's a great question, isn't it? Well, maybe because that was the most nerve-wracking kick he had to attempt all year. But he knocked it through just like it was an easy chip shot.
Now, we thought we might have a good post game, and we did when it came down to that final onside kick. They recovered it, but they would have had to return it. They were unable to do that, and that would have been
that. That is frustrating, isn't it, to execute an onside kick and get the ball? Yet there's no payoff for them. Right now they're probably in their locker room trying to comfort themselves with the clock just ran out on us. We were right there.
So for the Texans, the victory means they'll up their mark to 5-3 on the year. And now they'll have a few extra days here before they face the Giants next week. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, the perfect season was apparently not meant to be as they drop to 7-1. And they will be back home next week for a date with Washington.
What I never do. How you supposed to walk with me? I'm 86. shot, who me? Take that, ooh-wee. One shot, movie, that's all you need.
Hey. One shot, for everybody living in the moment. One shot is all you get, so you gotta own it. One shot, you only get one shot. One shot, for everybody living in the moment. One shot is all you get, so you gotta own it. One shot, you only get one shot.
First off, let me talk my got a couple things I gotta cross off my list. How you insomniac for sleeping on my it's a bad soundtrack, read the script. Born in the motherland, headed straight down to the south. Tennessee mornings with pops, working three jobs. I knew that they struggled to get it, that's why I wanted to get it. That's embedded, you get it, treat it like a law. And I'ma need commission for this hit. Lance laid the canvas and I painted over it. I don't need a vision board to show you I'm the I'm betting on myself. Chips.
Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest.
Try to sink my ship like Titanic and leave me with Jack. Hope I be panicking, but I rose to the top. Isn't it funny that the is built like a Maserati, yoga folding like origami?
What? I walk the walk. I talk the talk. I be saying what I want. When I had no deposit, closet was looking real bare. Now I made a deposit, my closet's looking super rare. Drove it really far. Crazy how did this happen, wishing on a star. It's a celebration, I ain't talking Mardi Gras. With a little patience, you'll be eating Buddha Khan. What you want? What you want?
Made some choices for a profit.
That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest.
Never let a man affect your stack like that. And if you're getting toxic, tell the boy fall back. If it was back then, I'd be tripping off that. Took a little time just to get me on track. I went from snotty to snobby, got it like, immune to everybody, this is start 101. Up in the club, throwing the strippies like, hate it, love it, I just can't get enough. Labels keep calling me, I said move if you call me please, or don't even bother me, they said oh my apology. They keep calling and calling, I keep stalling and stalling. Rookie of the year, my career's no ballin'.
Got it. Made some choices for a profit.
That's my logic.
I'ma
take it to the coffin. Just being honest.
Alright, my flow sinister. This ain't rap music, this straight literature. Small minded, all your ideas miniature. They tend to hate on you when they can't get rid of you. I ain't going nowhere, 20 year career minimum. Call Hit Boy for beats, ask for 10 of them. I don't follow trends, my swing the pendulum. If the bag good, I'm gonna give her some. Let's reflect times, I try to collect minds from complex rhymes. And by the way, shout out Tech N9ne. Go and shut the up, just let me talk. I'm a time bomb that's waiting to go off. Quite nuclear, amazing what fame could do to you. Too peculiar, although I'm truly a renaissance starter. My mind divine, it take me a lot farther. Growing up, I really had beef with my...
got my on a dental work. My thoughts I keep confidential. It's consequential. Philosophies unidentical. I'm not into ya. My Siamese brother Benjamin. That's how I stick to him. These diamond bees, all VBs. I call them Vivica. Skating underneath a bridge. Stay hustling as it is. Make money, feed the kids. Ain't nothing in the fridge. Wake up, repeat the sins. Hey, I need a 10. Stay muddy to the lid. 800, eat a.
Yeah, alright, my flow sinister. Yeah. This ain't rap music, this straight literature. Small-minded, all your ideas miniature. They tend to hate on you when they can't get rid of you. I ain't going nowhere, 20-year career minimum. Call hit boy for beats, ask for 10 of them. I don't follow trends, my I swing the pendulum. If the bag good, I'm gonna give her some. Yeah, all right, my flow sinister.